So I tell you, pastors, you better know which part of the Bible to take and which not. But the welfare system was started in the Bible, but pastors said, okay, we're going to split it. Whoever came up with this brilliant idea, I think it was the rulers, because they don't want to be governed by God's word, because they could break all the laws they want, even though they set in the laws, right? Donald Trump tell you it's wrong to grope girls' women's crotch, but he does it, right? All his cabinet after Bill Cosby is coming out as people who is degrading women. But they'll tell you that's legal. They set the laws and they break the laws. They don't want to be governed by God's law. Keep church and state separate. Oh, hell no. Better bring it back together if you want to see some change. I'm trying to tell you. The government, the law, don't got to live by God's law. And they say they Christians, but more perverted nonsense is coming out of the White House than ever before. Bill Clinton was one man, one woman. And we're going to look at it like that. You got Donald Trump and all his women. You got the men after him. Oh, what's the men's name? You know the one with the R. McCorp. I ain't gonna call their name because I don't want to get it messed up. Hell, even Russell Simmons and the black guys coming out. Let me just say the ratio like this. You had Bill Cosby, one man, allegedly 52 women, right? Okay. You got Donald Trump, say he allegedly 52 women. You got all the other people in his cabinet, say they allegedly 52 women. Golly. Oh, that's a lot, right? I'm saying allegedly. We know it's a few of them. But damn, they make the laws and they want to break the laws. But if they was governed by God's law, huh? They see their wife. They will see their wife a little bit more appealing, attractive, as one flesh, and wouldn't be out here groping all these other women. But they don't want to go by God's law. They want to make their own laws so they can break them. Mm-hmm. That's what they want to do. But you allow it. You allow it. We the people, and we gotta stop allowing it. People are afraid to speak up. Oh, you're going to get banned from this. You're going to be banned from that. They gonna blackball you. They going to blacklist you. I'm black and on several lists already. What the hell is any difference? Hello? Are we too worried about what we going to lose, where we can't go, who ain't going to respect us because we said this, that, or the third? Take a look around. People are saying the most hella shit on TV, off TV, and you, ooh, ha, ha, ha. Yeah, ooh, ha, 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 what? You are. You just, like, America is in a trance over a lot of stuff that we should not be in a trance over, and we just go along with it. Let me tell you something. And this is my point exactly, and I'm about to wrap it up. You in church, and the Bible talks about this too. It talks about a lot of stuff. And so I just be like, oh Lord, and these people running around here really doing this, and they say, don't do it? So anyway, you in church, somebody speaking in tongues. Let's keep it real. Do you know what they saying? And you all, hallelujah, Jesus. What the heck is they saying? See, that's the trance I'm talking about. That's the trance I'm talking about. Bible talks about that. And you just agreeing in the spirit. Don't even know what you're agreeing to. But that's how we are. We led by our visual. Oh, it looks good. We led by our hearing. Oh, it sounds good. But is it right? Is it right? Is it right? That's all I'm asking you. is learn what's right, learn what's wrong. I had 40 years believing something of Christianity and then have this stuff be hit with you. Like, wait a minute, God. Well, he said, Drew, people perish for lack of knowledge. Look around. People perishing. The only thing they could say out their mouth is, Jesus love me. Jesus love you. What else? We dying because we don't have the word of God in us. When I say dying, that's a spiritual death. We falling by the wayside, left and right. Left and right, we missing the mark. Left and right, we being eaten up, taken down, this, that, and the third. Left and right. That's crazy. And yeah, I'm passionate about this because this is supposed to be like a we're supposed to be soldiers and soldiers for Christ, ambassadors for Christ. Well, we don't put up that fight. We let people come in, take stuff from us, tell us we gotta live by this rule, live by that rule, but this Look, it's rules in the Bible, laws in the Bible. God probably say in his commandments, statutes, ordinances, and laws, don't do, but then you gotta follow the laws of men, and we probably have to do it. Like worship a flag, I'ma say it, you damn right. Is it in the Bible for me to worship a flag? But your president will make it such a damn stinking riot over a flag who people saved your life, not the damn flag. People saved your life, not the flag. But see, they'll throw the flag up like they're Crip or Blood. What would they be? Blitz? Blitz? They'll be Blitz in the White House. They'd be Crips and Blood mixed together up in there. But they throwing up their flag. I'm sorry. The flag don't save my life. The flag probably put me in more danger than anything, if you really think about the flag and what it really represents and how they was out there fighting the damn war. They probably had no reason fighting and trying to sell people into slavery and steal people and all this. Oh, the queen and her country, you know, the queen and the American government is like cousins, little brothers and sisters. They'll try to tell you that in prophecy, that the United Kingdom and America is related. Now, I'm going to tell you, and it ain't no prophecy, Donald Trump from Germany, and he trying to make Jerusalem, if not already did it, the capital of Israel over there. Now, did God want that? If God wanted that, it'd have been the capital way back. Jerusalem is the city that Christ was to return to. Donald Trump wants to go over there and sit on the throne before Christ get there. I said it. Yeah, I said it. He wants to go over there and probably be Christ himself. What else have he accomplished? He, according to him, he accomplished everything else in his life. Maybe that's on his bucket list to get his ass over there in Jerusalem and try to be the high priest. Honey, let me tell you something. Is you paying attention? Is you really woke? I'm trying to tell you. That's a whole nother teaching. I gotta have notes on that. I gotta have video for that. I'll show you all of that. That is some truth going on with Donald Trump and the United Kingdom today. As we speak. With Jerusalem being the capital of Israel. But when it comes to this religion, when I hear the Pope say, oh, Jesus is a baby in the manger, and he po, and I go, my hat goes out to all you po people who follow Jesus, and let me tell you something. Jesus was not poor. Jesus' followers was not poor, even in spirit. It wasn't until the Roman Empire went raking hell all through the Middle East over there to try to do away with the followers of Christ. That's how this all got started. That's how to split the divide. Some Muslims went that way. Americans got this way. Some Indians went that way. People went this way. Hitler says that you are Negroid.